Hey y'all, what's going on? Welcome back to Vlogmas Day 4, and today is going to be kind of different because I'm going to be sharing with y'all an initiative that is really, really important to me and something I try to help out as much as possible. And I love that my favorite sport ever is the sport that sponsors this a ton. So today we're going to talk about Hockey Fights Cancer. In the NHL, the AHL, they both do this, and this is a huge initiative that they do during the month of November, and they do a little bit into December, but since December is a huge month of giving, I figured this would be a great time to talk to you guys about this and show you guys what NHL teams do, including my Carolina Hurricanes, to help with Hockey Fights Cancer. Founded in 1998 by the National Hockey League, that's right, the NHL, and the National Hockey League Players Association, really long word, Hockey Fights Cancer unites the hockey community to help support cancer patients and their families. This initiative gets coaches, players, officials. It gets the equipment managers, front office staff, corporate partners, and fans together to inspire hope and courage for those who are living with, going through, and moving past cancer. So this could be people who have family members, this could be themselves. It's a huge initiative, and it really, the NHL does a fantastic job with this. So during the whole month of November, all the hockey teams are lit up purple. So it's a huge thing. And it's just, every team does such a great job doing their own Hockey Fights Cancer. And so one night for every team is Hockey Fights Cancer Night. So this year for us, it was at the end of November, and they had some special jerseys that were put together for the warm-ups for the players to wear. And on each of their numbers, it was people's names that have battled cancer, everything. And then they were black jerseys and they were designed in purple. Our Hurricanes logo was purple. They did a fantastic job of this, and I'll show you some pictures real quick. These jerseys were are auctioned off after the game for the proceeds to go back to the American Cancer Society and everything like that. So even the jerseys helped give back to Hockey Fights Cancer. Now during the game, each team has their own celebrations that they do, and one thing that is common for all teams is that they have these I Fight for cards that you can fill out. So everybody's is different depending on who, like, what relationship you have to people. Some people who don't have any at all will just write for patients, survivors, whoever. But if you have a loved one like I do who has battled cancer, you can write their name on there. People who've lost their lives to cancer, it's really important. So my card, I Fight for Mimi Pa and my grandmother. I have three grandparents who have battled cancer, whether it's breast, colon, stomach, whatever it is. They have battled it. I am lucky enough that my grandparents are, all three of them are still alive and here with me today. I know that's not the same with a lot of people. But I am one of the lucky ones and I fight for them every day. And this is something that's extremely important to me, and really close to my heart. So when they are doing Hockey Fights Cancer, they are paired up with three different organizations. They do American Cancer Society, the Canadian Cancer Society, and then the Movember Foundation. Now the Movember Foundation is the mustache, you know, no shave November, that kind of thing. They, a lot of teams do this. So through this, those three organizations support people affected by cancer, their families, and their caregivers. And some of the ways they do this are with lodging, transportation, vital programs, and symptoms management support, which are all four very important things that people who have cancer patients truly understand how important those are. And I beg, and I know some people may not understand this at all, but it's super important, and it's something that we should have a huge amount of support for. I'm going to leave these three organizations linked down below so you can go research some more. If you want to donate, you can donate to them. And I will leave the Hockey Fights Cancer information link down below as well, because that is super important. It's something so simple you can donate and give to. But I want to show you guys some of the things that took place during some of the different teams' initiative for Hockey Fights Cancer and their night, some of the videos that were posted by teams for who they fight for, and some interviews with cancer patients. So I'm going to show you guys those right now.
Hockey community is a family.
And like most families, we all know someone who's been affected by cancer.
I fight for kids. I fight for grandpa.
I fight for my family.
I fight for a cure.
I fight for Krista.
I fight for Anneli.
I fight for the patients.
I fight for my grandma.
I fight for families.
I fight for survivors.
Join forces with the National Hockey League and the National Hockey League of Players Association for Hockey Fights Cancer Night.
Welcome back to Hockey Legends, Tom Kerbers and Brian Renfrew.
Wild fans, this is our ice.
Let's play hockey! No matter the team, we are all together in the fight against cancer. Welcome to the game, Layla.
You can get a buzz cut and support our Hockey Fights Cancer charity partners.
Mark Self.
My name is Tyler.
My name is Howard Margulies.
My name is Faith Patino.
I'm Charlene West.
My name is Lindsay Kennedy, and this is Carter Mae Kennedy.
My name is Abby, and my favorite player is Jacob Slavin.
I went for my yearly physical in 2017, and they saw something that did not look right.
When I was playing basketball, I had issues with my leg, and my leg was bothering me.
I ran into Mommy and Daddy's room, and I always said to Mommy or Daddy, my head hurt.
So they did a biopsy, it came back, and they said it was cancer.
And then they found that I had a brain tumor.
I was diagnosed with breast cancer. Carter Mae was diagnosed with stage 4 Wilms tumor. That is a large tumor of the kidney.
I'd say one of the most difficult parts for me is always waiting.
It just takes a lot of time away, especially when you're not feeling good.
There are times where I have days where I have no energy and I just kind of lay around, sit on the couch.
Not being able to be at school every day and do the same things as everyone else.
All these doctors and people came in and they're like doing everything on me, and that kind of made me scared.
Everybody's fighting a different kind of battle.
We all have scars. Some are external, some are internal, and some are emotional scars.
Cancer is so devastating to the family and to the child involved, like Carter Mae, and so having that support and exposure is really important to help us feel strong.
Hockey and all sports, watching them is really like kind of therapeutic or calming, and because like it's one of my favorite things to watch.
This is actually my happy place, so it kind of lifts my spirits and makes me feel better.
It's just a relief for us to be able to come to the games and just get away from our everyday life.
I think to me that's important, to not let cancer kind of be everything about you.
You really find out people that really care about you.
Love and support from family and friends is huge.
They all told me one day, like, yeah, we're gonna shave our heads. it was really awesome to see like all of them do that, and I don't feel like I'm, you know, alone in the fight.
I actually just finished my chemo treatments October 10th.
And she has been cancer-free since May.
As of 2 weeks ago, I am now cancer-free.
What I try to do is take it one day at a time, because it's really hard to look into the future and see like how much longer you have to go.
You have to have a positive attitude in anything, but especially when you're diagnosed with cancer.
If I ever did have a message, I probably would say you're okay because you have doctors and your parents here, and you're also in good hands.
I think it's important just to never give up and enjoy every day.
My name is Faith, and I am a fighter.
I am Carter May, and I'm a big survivor.
I'm a fighter.
I'm a survivor.
I'm a survivor.
And I'm a fighter.
My name is Abby, and I am a survivor.
The lavender tape on the sticks of each of the players on the blue lines today represents the Hockey Fights Cancer program. On the ice, all members of the Dallas Stars and your Edmonton Oilers are holding I Fight For cards to honor their individual cancer heroes and causes. As we celebrate the strength and spirit of survivors and fighters and continue to help raise awareness and funds in their battle against cancer, we invite Oilers fans to turn on the flashlights on your cell phones and join us in a moment of silence as we honor those who have survived or are currently fighting a battle with cancer. Thank you. Today, we have a very special guest with us representing the Kids with Cancer Society. 8-year-old Emmett Brosseau was diagnosed with ALL, acute lymphoblastic leukemia, when he was 4 years old. For 3 years and 3 months, Emmett endured extensive cancer care with the support of Kids with Cancer Society. Emmett stayed positive and thrived throughout his battle and proudly finished his last treatment just 4 weeks ago. His positive attitude and love for the Oilers made Emmett the perfect ambassador to be featured in this year's Hockey Fights Cancer Toque Sale Initiative. These toques are available today throughout the building, with proceeds going towards the Kids with Cancer Society BrainWorks program. At this time, it is our honor to welcome to the ice cancer survivor, 8-year-old Emmett Brosseau. Emmett is being accompanied today by his father, Jake. We now ask the captain from the Stars, Jimmy Benn, and Oilers Hockey Fights Cancer Ambassador James Neal to join Emmett at center ice for today's ceremonial puck drop. Losing friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In 2D, say I'm in 2D. It's been 2 years. This is my fight song. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for today's Hockey Fights Cancer Child Ambassador, Emmett Brosseau.
Today's Hockey Fights Cancer Ambassador, Leighton Accardo, was diagnosed with stage 4 malignant germ cell tumors back in May. She is currently undergoing chemotherapy at Phoenix Children's Hospital and still has a tough road ahead, but with the love and the support of so many friends, family, strangers, and the local community, Leighton is here today, fresh off a new contract with the Coyotes, to drop the ceremonial puck.
For
Thank you, Oliver, Mark, and once again, let's hear it for Leighton Ricardo.
What a moment.
And Derek Stepan scored the first goal, and I know it was kind of cool because you were in there and you got to, a lot of the guys were kind of touching your head, and then you actually rubbed Derek's head. Do you think you gave him good luck?
Yeah.
I do too. We're gonna look at that actually, because I think that was a really cool moment. and there it is. Pretty amazing. I love it.
And of course, today's first star of the game, the Coyotes' newest acquisition, number 49, Leighton Ricardo!
Well, this caps a wonderful afternoon for Leighton Ricardo, and her energy is boundless out there. She's dealing with cancer. She's going through treatment. She had a baseball game earlier today. She took an at-bat, and she has some limited mobility in that left foot, but you can't really tell from what she's doing out there. She wanted to take that lap. She's been out on the ice for the pregame warm-up. She spoke to the team. She is so inspiring for everyone watching this right now, and her smile, it just lights up the room.
To some, this may look like a simple card, but when you add a name to it, it becomes so much more. It goes from being easy to lift to being capable of lifting up millions. It becomes a symbol of love, a badge of defiance. It sends a message that our bonds are stronger than cancer. It says that we are family. We stick together and refuse to give up. So yes, to some it may look like a simple card, but once you write a name on it, it means so much more. Visit HockeyFightsCancer.com and donate today.
Like I said, all these organizations will be linked down below so you can go and give. I strongly suggested there's nothing better than around this giving season to give to people that are going through a lot. Their families are going through a lot. It's impossible to imagine what each family is going through. It's a different circumstance for every family. But I urge you to give. I urge you to participate in some way, to make your own fundraiser, to raise money for people, or to go volunteer somewhere at a hospital, just to give back to people so you can go and brighten their day. So you guys, that was Vlogmas Day 4. I hope you guys enjoy this, and I will see you guys back here for Vlogmas Day 5. Bye, y'all.